celebrating Christmas Eve in the Rhode Show kitchen with one of our favorites, Nick Raybar, who I just found out is a fan of a good battery-operated sweater.
And I mean, who doesn't love something that is operating off of a couple of AAAs right now, right?
Pretty nice.
Better be AAA, because that's lightweight. If you're carrying around D's in there,
definitely
that's a little
not.
Heavy. You're going to be
How
like
about those
lopsided.
Tiny watch batteries.
Like, that could be those.
It's a pain to find.
Which I'll never know what those sizes are, you know?
No.
It's too much for me to deal with. But you know what's not too much for me to deal with? Johnny cakes.
Yes,
we're
going to
make Johnny cakes. Yes. Especially because, you know, Christmas is such a fun time to do something a little different. And if you're waking up, many people are waking up early with the kiddos or because they have to go travel to be with family, whatever the case may be, this is such a simple and fun recipe.
But a crowd pleaser.
But a big crowd pleaser, especially in Rhode Island.
Yeah, so, and a different take if you're used to making pancakes.
Totally.
Try Johnny cakes.
Well, I mean, that's what it is. It's, it's a pancake made with cornmeal, all right? And, you know, it's very much known in Rhode Island as a Rhode Island tradition.
Yes.
And so I'm using the white cornmeal here, which is the Johnny cake, you know, the actual Johnny cake cornmeal, which I'm simply going to mix with a little bit of boiling water,
a
pinch of sugar, and a little bit of salt.
Nice.
Now, that's your Johnny cake right there. Put butter and put maple syrup and call it a day. But we're going to just do something slightly different.
You always do.
Always slightly different. So I've got some candied, some pecans here that we're going to candy with a little bit of chopped applewood bacon. Now, I think this is like, this looks like you got sugar, you have honey, you have maple. It looks like breakfast for Buddy the Elf here, okay? But I need to, so I need
hide
to add
up my sleep.
Yeah, I know. You right, exactly. I got the syrup. But I'm going to add that savory component to it.
Okay.
Now, I also have a couple of fabulous little Rhode Island, all of this is Rhode Island stuff.
Yeah.
Now, if you're waking up this morning on Christmas Eve and you're looking for a few last minute gift ideas, we're opening a pantry today.
Good.
And we have some
of
these things here, okay? So we have the Kenyon's Johnny Cake White Corn Meal Mix that we're gonna use this today. This is from right here in Rhode Island. And then I have this fabulous Rhode Island maple syrup from my buddy at Charlie's in Coventry.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have a Butter Cuisine cinnamon butter, which we're gonna finish these with.
I know we've used other butters of theirs, but the cinnamon butter.
Yeah, cinnamon butter is gonna
be
fun.
Nice treat.
Yes.
Okay. Get ready. Hope you're hungry. Get out your battery-operated sweater, and we'll get cooking in just a bit. Thanks so much, Will. We were just enjoying him sitting on the couch. He looked like he was very peaceful.
Oh, my, his little lonesome self.
He was very peaceful. Well, you know what? He is probably getting a whiff of all of the deliciousness happening in the kitchen today.
This is great stuff. This is great stuff. So in this pan, I took a little bit of honey and a little bit of sugar, and I put in the pecans and the bacon. Tiny bit of butter, okay?
Pecans or pecans?
Pecans, whichever you prefer
pecans.
On this fabulous Christmas Eve.
Could you even do walnuts or something?
You can totally do walnuts.
Kind of whatever you have.
100%.
All right.
100%. Now, I'm going to get that out of there because you want to be real careful. When you're making caramel and sugar, it can burn very easy.
There's a fine line.
Very fine line.
Ready and over.
And we've reached it.
Okay.
So we're going to put that aside. All right, now that's the goal there. That's what you want to see so you can like spread that around. Now over here.
And you know the consistency. Sorry to cut you
off.
The consistency that you look for, kind of that syrup, you want it to gel together enough, and that's when you know. Okay.
You do. And as it's going to sit, it might even absorb a little bit and harden up. So
great.
You want to be cautious. Now, over here, I have that fabulous Johnny cake mix.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's hit it up with a pinch of sugar.
Okay.
Now, in this day and age, Johnny cakes, you can do whatever you want. If you want the baking powder in there, no matter what you want to add to it, you really, really can. It's not that big of a deal. But traditionally, the old school recipe is just the cornmeal, a little bit of water, salt, and sugar.
Okay.
Now, I've got very hot water here. Now, it's right below boiling point. They say boil.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have to necessarily be boiling if it's out of your comfort zone. And I'm going to start to mix that up. And you can see, while it looks like a decent amount of water, that's all going to really come together here.
Yes.
And then what we're going to do is we're going to start to go into this pan here. Okay, it's going to be over medium heat. We're going to put a decent amount of butter in there.
I was going to say, what do you need to prep
butter,
your pan
baby.
With?
Butter, right. Butter, butter. Okay, this is, you know, you're making, see how that's coming together? So it looked like it was going to be a little, and luckily I have a little bit more here because that's just a touch too much water. But you can always kind of eyeball it, feel it to consistency. You want to make this kind of like what a pancake would be.
Yeah, and some people, like you said, consistency, some people have a runnier batter. Some people like it a little thicker. So I like that you're kind of playing around, a little more water, a little more.
Totally. And we've reached that point of perfection right now. So you can see that there, how it's all coming together. The boiling water will help dissolve the cornmeal. Okay,
sure.
Now this is a very fine. This is Rhode Island. This is Rhode Island at its best. This
Kenyon's. Yep.
You know it. I mean,
yeah.
I don't even know how to really pronounce where it's from. Is it Usapog? Ouskapog?
What does it say on it?
I know it's a strange little part of Rhode Island. I feel like it's down by Adamsville, like in that part of the state.
No one has ever heard of this.
I show them. And it's this fabulous old...
Ouskapog?
Like, yeah. Ouskapog? Ouskapeg? Ouskapog. Someone's got to know.
Ouskapeg?
Who's a historian around here? I don't know what's going on. But what I do know is that that came out perfect. And so Rhode Island has so much history. I mean, that's been there since the 1800s or something,
early
90s. Like, it's really, really long time. And again, we're going to match it up with some of this gorgeous Rhode Island syrup and some of the butter cuisine as well.
Awesome. All right. Well, we've got our batter ready. We've got the pecans.
We got the pecans, the pecans.
The pecans, the pecans, however you pronounce it. It's delicious either way. And we'll cook up these giant cakes coming up a little later on in the show.
Back to you.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Our own St. Nick is here. Nick Raybar Avenue. And
man, oh man.
Johnny Cakes are on the menu
today.
A Rhode Island favorite for years and years and years. And I know you were talking with Michaela about where they make this.
Yeah, at the old gristmill. Yeah,
it's a great
beautiful.
Place. So fun
beautiful.
To watch them how they do it.
A lot of history there, and I advise everyone to go there. And if you're looking for the product locally, we do have it in the pantry.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can get it at Dave's.
Right.
And I'm sure you can get it elsewhere. But it really is the product
it's
to use.
It's the one.
It dissolves really well, but still leaves a little bit of texture, which I think is what you're looking for. I mean,
so it's cornmeal, right?
It's all cornmeal.
Cornmeal, right.
And that's the fun of this, is basically it's a pancake, but instead of using flour, we're using cornmeal.
Right.
And we're using a kind of a fine white cornmeal here that is made at the grist mill right here in Rhode Island, which is, you know, just fun for all sorts of different reasons.
Yeah.
If you're looking for it, we have it in the pantry, and you can make these fabulous little Johnny Cakes right here.
And I'm telling you, when Nick says it's made at the grist mill, like, they do it the way that it was originally done, with giant stones rolling over the corn. I remember being there, seeing the corn being dropped off, the stone rolling
so
over
cool.
it, crushing it into that fine powder. It's about as authentic, it really hasn't changed in hundreds of years.
No, and they would like, this recipe here is the recipe like that I use that they advise.
Right.
And it's very bare bones.
Yeah.
So you're talking about the cornmeal and water.
Okay.
If you do that and do that only, you're in good shape, because it has that sort of grainy flavor that you're looking for the Johnny Cake, and then we're going to top with all these other little things.
Right.
But I add just a little bit of sugar and salt as well. Now, if you're looking for like something fluffier, which is sort of, you know, Johnny Cake blasphemy, you can add a little bit of baking powder. But, you know, the goal here is to have those, I don't like the word dense because it has a negative connotation, but you really do want that. You want that grain, you want that sort of denser Johnny Cake, and it's very, very neutral, which is nice, so then you can just add a few things to it. So I'm going to give them one more flip wheel, and I've sort of had them going here for about...
They look great.
Yeah, they are. This is sort of like what you're looking for a Johnny Cake. And when I put them in the pan, I kind of scoop them a little tall,
right,
and they'll fall down a little bit also. If you go too thin, you lose a little bit of like the center.
Right.
You know what I mean? And you kind of just gain like the crispiness on the outside, which is great. I'm griddling them in this cast iron pan over medium heat in a little bit of butter.
And I think that's exactly how and I believe that they told us when we were there, they would make these so that when the farmers would go out in the morning, they could carry these. It was easy to kind of basically wrap them up
and eat them
in the morning while they were working on the farm.
So
they
cool, isn't it?
Down and hang on to
which is such, which is so cool. And like I said, just major Rhode Island history. And we're going to go right onto the plate here. And it's just, I love this kind of stuff.
I do too.
And especially Christmas, you know, you're doing something a little bit different. You're looking for, you know, anything. Like, if you got your plans all set, so be it. You can use these Johnny Cakes for anything. They're actually really good with seafood, if you can believe it. You could put like an old-fashioned like lobster, like almost like Newberg style sauce over top.
Yeah.
So let's go on with these, Will. Let's get them a little plate presentation here. Okay.
Got it.
All right. Now, I've made this pecan and bacon sort of, you see how that came together
so
perfectly?
That looks nice.
Like I told Mick in between, like, it's going to absorb and it's going to dry out. So let's go on with this here. And this is that pecan bacon. I don't know what the right word. It's like candied, you know what I mean? It's not quite a brittle, but it is. It adds a ton of flavor, and that's going to add a ton of texture as well. Now,
it looks so good.
It's sweet, so you don't need to go nuts with the syrup. But since we're here, Will, and we're making Johnny Cakes, I happen to have this Rhode Island syrup here from my buddy Charlie at his sugar house in Coventry. We have a lot of great maple in this area. And we'll just go on with that. Now, I don't know, Will, are you a sweet breakfast guy or are you a savory breakfast guy?
I am a very easy when it comes to all of it. I love, like, that I would, that would be fantastic.
Isn't it so simple and so delicious? Now, I also have from my friends at Butter Cuisine here. a nice use for their sweet butter.
We haven't seen them in a while because of everything that's been going on, but anytime they bring in any of their butters, they are always so good, and they go with everything. They have
they
different
go
type
for everything. Yeah. They go with everything, and I use their garlic
so which
butter.
One, which one is that?
This is cinnamon.
Okay.
So cinnamon and bacon truly go fabulous together, Will.
Right.
And and obviously it goes perfect with Johnny cakes, and it goes perfect with pecans, so we'll just put a little bit of that on there. Okay, and that's going to melt down nicely.
So,
yeah, I mean, that's your sort of different
look at how
know,
nice
use
looks.
For Johnny cake there. And it's very brown and it's very neutral, but it's
right.
very, very delicious. And, like, when you dive into that, you're eating, you know, not just the history and the tradition,
right.
but you're also, I have three products there that are right from Rhode Island,
right,
New Hampshire bacon, like killer stuff.
Yeah. Well, Nick, if I can tell you, just happy, have a great Christmas.
Thanks,
Will.
And
the Ray Bar family, thanks for being with us and for all you do here all the time and for feeding us throughout the year with incredible, incredible food. Go see
Nick. My pleasure.
See Nick at Avenue N in Rumford and also in Providence. Go check out the pantry as well. We love having you here. And
thanks, buddy.
We love you.
Right back at you. Merry Christmas.
God, we're very sentimental.
We are very sentimental. It must be the holidays.
It's gotta be the holidays.
Is it the eggnog we were sipping on earlier?
Maybe the eggnog.
Could be the eggnog.
Send things back to you.